Hey everyone, this is Jyotika and welcome to your 18th HTML5 tutorial. Today, let's talk about tables and how you can use them to display some data on your website. If you have been in the web development field for some time now, then you might have heard that you should never use a table and that tables are really bad way to present content on your page. Well, that's because back during the early days of HTML, when we did not have CSS or any proper tools for styling or laying out our content on a web page, people weren't using tables for the reason they were supposed to use. Instead, they were using tables to kind of set things out nicely on the screen. They were making a huge table and laying out all the content of their page in different rows or columns. Things maybe looked okay, but the semantics were terrible. The content wasn't accessible, it wasn't reusable, it wasn't findable. The whole point of semantic HTML is to tell computers everywhere what the thing you have on your page is. If you have a button, use the button element. If you have navigational links, use the nav element. So what should we be using HTML tables for? Well, tabular data. Any bit of information that's best communicated by aligning things into rows and columns like prices of items, list of employees in a company can be considered as data table. And that's what tables are for. The data might be numbers, but not always. It could also be text or even images. So let's look at how to create a table in HTML. But before you even start coding a single thing, you might want to sketch out a layout of what your table should look like. Trust me, it will be a lot easier for you to write clean code the first time by doing this than to fix a broken code later. Now, one of the most important things to know when you are sketching out your tables is that the browser's expecting there to be the same number of cells on every single row. So if you don't design accordingly, then it's going to look very messy. Once you have decided what your table should look like, then it's time to start thinking about the tags. The table element defines an HTML table. It has both an opening and a closing tag. It's basically just a container element that's going to hold all the other tags inside it, which actually make up the rows and columns of the table. To create a table row, the tr element is used. In this table, we have three tr elements representing each row. Then, to create each cell in our table, we use the td element. So, this row here is one tr element, and inside that, you will create two separate td elements representing each of the two data cells in this row. Then, for each table header cell, we use the th elements, which are again inside a tr element. By default, the text in the th elements is bold and centered, and the text in the td elements is regular and left aligned. Now let's get this into our HTML file. We start with a table element to mark the container for all our table content. So the table that we sketched out has a total of 4 rows. So let's use the tr element to mark up each row. 4 pairs of tr opening and closing tags make 4 rows. Let's save this and have a look at the browser. Well, you don't actually see anything on the page yet, and that's because you haven't added any content inside your table. So let's put some content inside each row. The topmost row of our table contains the header cells. So to create the header cells, we use the th element. 2 pairs of th opening and closing tags for the 2 header cells. And then the text goes inside it. Save this, and you can see that we have our 2 header cells on the page now. Now let's fill in the rest of the content. We will use the td element now to represent each of the other regular data cells. Again, each row has 2 cells. So each of our tr elements will contain 2 td elements, 2 pairs of td opening and closing tags inside each tr element. and then we can fill in the cell content. You can have many different types of elements inside the TD element, like the P element, anchor element, image element. So there's a whole lot of content that can go in these cells. And there you go, you have a simple table on your page now. It doesn't really look like a table just yet, as it's missing all those table borders. But that can be easily done using CSS. We are not going into the details of styling today, but I'm still going to keep this CSS so that it's easier to show you the different table cells. And you can see we have our table with 4 rows, including this header row, which has the header cells bold and centered by default. And the other 3 rows contain 3 cells each, which were created using the TD elements, and their content is regular and left aligned. Of course, you can change all this style using CSS, but this is as simple as you can get as far as a table goes. You can have even more rows with TH elements. Maybe you have another section in your table that needs a separate header. Then you can go ahead and put more TH elements in those rows. Now this TH element is a semantic element, which stands for table heading. It indicates that this isn't data. This is actually the name of the data that we are looking at. So don't use regular TD elements here instead and make them bold using CSS. As people looking at it using assistive devices might think, oh hey look, this is bold, so it must be more important. We don't want to give that impression. So always use the TH element for the header cells and not the TD elements. Next, let's talk about captions. So how do we link some caption to our table? What people used to do earlier is they would put in some sort of heading using H2 or H3 elements, and they would put it right above or right below the table. So visually, if you were looking at it, you could kind of figure out, oh, this heading goes with this table. But writing a heading this way doesn't link it with the table. It's just 2 different elements sitting next to each other. And it doesn't convey any meaning to people using screen readers or to search engines. So instead of doing that, you can use the caption element inside the table, and it will help everyone know visually and semantically that, oh, this caption goes with this specific table. And it must be inserted immediately after the table tag. Don't write it inside any TR or TD elements. But you can write it anywhere immediately inside the table element. For example, here I have written it before the other elements in the table tag. And here I have written it after all the table elements. However, it will not affect the position of the caption. By default, a table caption will always be center aligned and above the table. But you can use CSS to align and place the caption differently. Next, you can go even further and group your table content into a table header, table body, and a table footer. For example, in this table of monthly savings, you can wrap this entire row of header cells in the T-head element. Note that both the opening and closing tags of the TR element are included inside the T-head. Then the main rows, which have the data cells of all the months, can be put inside the T-body element. And finally, the last row of the total savings inside the T-foot element. These are all semantic elements, and they are used just for grouping your table content into different parts. They don't apply any special styling to your table, as you can see in the browser. Also, these are all optional. It's not compulsory to use all 3 of them. You can skip all or any of them according to the design of your table. Browsers can use these elements to enable scrolling of the table body independently of the header and footer. And also, while printing a large table that spans multiple pages, these elements can enable the table header and footer to be printed at the top and bottom of each page. We can also create a complex table that spans multiple rows or multiple columns. It might be the case that sometimes the table you want to make isn't some sort of a perfect grid or has equal number of rows or columns. So to do that, you can combine multiple rows or multiple columns using the row span and call span attributes. Inside your th or td elements, you would include call span equals 2 if you wanted to span two columns, or row span equals 3 if you wanted to have it span 3 rows. Here in this simple table, I have headings as name and favorite fruit. And then I have a person, and with each person, their favorite fruit. But here, I have row span equals 2 for John, which means I actually want my John cell to take up two horizontal lines. Same with the Tina cell. Dan I have left alone. So let's just look at the end result. And I have the person and their favorite fruit. And here are the two cells where I did the row span. And you can see it actually took up multiple rows, because in this case, John and Tina both had two favorite fruits that we wanted to include. Similarly, you can also have call span attribute if you wanted some table to have a particular cell span across multiple columns. It looks complicated as there are a lot of tags, but if you plan your table layout properly, then it is actually very simple. So yeah, that's HTML tables for you. Tables that should only be used for tabular data. Don't use it for page layout. It's not a hard concept. If you take the time to sketch out your table prior to coding and think about the different tags you are going to use. Because otherwise it just gets very messy and harder to debug. Also, most important thing is that you need to check for unclosed tags. Browsers will sometimes forgive your mistakes, but not always. So make sure you validate your code using an online validator whenever you write a table, or really whenever you write any code. I will be putting today's code and some interesting links in the description below, so don't forget to check it out. You can also add today's code to any web page that we have worked on so far in the previous tutorials, so that you have all the HTML tags in one place to refer later. Also, let me know in the comments if you have any questions. This is Jyotika signing off. Until next time, keep learning and keep coding.